This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video two of solving equations with decimals, and we're going to do these three problems on this video. So here's the first one. We're going to start out the same as we did from the first video. I've got x minus 3.2, so we want to add 3.2 to both sides. But we've got to be careful here when we simplify the right-hand side. You have negative 4.6 plus 3.2, so you have to think, all right, I'm adding a positive and a negative number, and I've got negative 4.6, and I have positive 3.2. So the answer is going to be negative, so we write the negative. And then the second part is, when you're adding a positive and negative, you subtract the smaller from the larger, right? So it's written in that form, so you could go ahead and just see that you've got already got the bigger number on top, 4.6 and 3.2. So that's going to give you a 1.4. Or you might go over into your side work over here. Say I'm going to do 4.6 minus 3.2. That might be easier. You don't see those positive and negative numbers in the way. So there's our answer, and we're just going to check it. So we write the problem, and we're going to replace x with negative 1.4. Right? And now we have to simplify the left side. So we've got negative 1.4 minus 3.2, and those are both, that's like adding negative 1.4 plus a negative 3.2. So you're adding two negatives. You know it's going to be negative. And go over here and just add them up. 1.4 and 3.2 add up to 4.6. So this is negative 4.6. That's what the left side simplifies to. And on the right, I see I also happen to have a negative 4.6, so it checks. So our answer over here, written in braces to show the solution set, would be negative 1.4. All right, here's our next problem. Similar. Again, we're going to start off by subtracting the 1.1 from each side. And then we've got to use our rules for what's going on over here. I've got negative 3.5 and I'm subtracting 1.11, or just adding a negative 1.11. So be careful with your signs and what's going on here. You're adding two negatives, and so when you add two negatives, it's going to be negative. And then you could add the two numbers. So I could put a zero placeholder here if you want, and let's just add them up as you see them. 4.61. And we're done. Okay, let's check it, of course. So that was the original problem. We're going to put in negative 4.61 for x. Alright, so I'm adding a positive and a negative number, right? So when you add a positive and negative number, you see which one outweighs the other. There's more negatives. So my answer is going to be negative. And then we subtract the smaller, you know, the absolute value, the smaller one from the other, the larger one. So I'm going to do that little arithmetic over here. 4.61 minus 1.11 is 3.50, and that simplifies to just 3.5. You don't need to write that extra zero. And on the right I have negative 3.5. There's nothing to do, so you know what? That checks. So this is the correct answer. And if we write it in the braces showing it's the solution set, that's what it'll look like. Alright, one more. So we have x plus 14 equals 12.3. So again, we just start off by subtracting 14. So if you want, you could put negative 14 or negative 14.0, but this is hard to do in this form. So we want to think about that, what's really going on here. Well, I'm adding a positive and a negative again. So are there more positives or negatives? There's more negatives, so it's going to be negative. And then how do we do that problem? And by the way, let's say you didn't write the 0.14, I mean the 14.0. So how do you do this? Adding a positive and a negative, you take the big number minus a small number. So I'm going to do that scratch work over here. I'm going to do the 14 minus the 12.3, but you need to put that zero up there in order to do the subtraction. Remember, that is not 2.3. And so now how you go ahead and do your arithmetic here. So we've got 1.7. So it's the answer then is negative 1.7. So let's check it. Okay, so we're putting negative 1.7 in for x and adding 14. All right, so we're adding a negative and a positive. So how do you add a negative and a positive? You decide if you know which is the bigger absolute value. It's going to be positive since 14 is bigger than 1.7. So we know it's positive. And then you subtract the smaller number minus the larger. So let's do that side work arithmetic over here. I've got to do 14 minus 1.7. And again, remember that's not 13.7. You need to put the decimal point and put the zero there. And now we can subtract. So that's going to be 12.3. So negative 1.7 plus 14 is 12.3. So the left side simplifies to 12.3. And the right-hand side is already simplified. So it checked. So that means this is the correct answer. So writing that in solution set notation, we have negative 1.7. And voila. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.